Today I'm just going to be doing this prom-ish look. It's dramatic and it's out of the box for prom, but I just wanted to try this out, and since I haven't done a prom makeup tutorial yet, I just thought I would do this one. This is also can be a summer look. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy, and let's get started. So for prom, you're going to want your makeup to stay on all day and all night through dancing and sweating, and also through the heat if it is hot out while you're taking pictures. So we're just going to be starting off with a dip brow for your eyebrows. A powder will come off more easily. So if you do use a dip brow, then you will have that lasting forever. And this dip brow pomade lasts a lifetime. Seriously, it does not come off. So now that your eyebrows are nice and dark and long lasting, we are just going to be starting with the eyes today, because there might be fallout from our shadow and we really don't want to have to try and get the fallout off of our fully baked face. So let's just start out with me taking Matt's Painterly Paint Pot and using this as my eyebrow, my eyelid primer. I'm just going to take a little concealer brush like this and just take some of the Painterly Paint Pot onto my brush and just put that on my eyelids. Priming your eyelids will just make sure that the shadows stay all day and that they are more vibrant and opaque. Usually eyeshadows without a eyeshadow primer aren't as bright and, I don't even know what I'm saying. So first I'm just going to be taking my Coastal Scents eyeshadow pot in Oatmeal Tan. It's just a very, very nice transitioning color. So I'm going to take this on my fluffy Sigma E25 blending brush. The place where you put your brush first is where you will get the most pigment at. So you just want to start at the outer corner and drag in towards the crease. This is just a really nice transitioning color. And I keep my eyelid open because if I had it closed, I would not see where my crease would end up if I opened my eye. So I just look down slightly and put the crease color. I'm just going to be taking this Sephora eyeshadow. It's in the color Indian Summer. It's a really nice orangey shade. But yeah, I'm just going to take that on the same E25. And it's almost the same color, but it's more of a peach toned. I'm just going to take that and put that in of my crease right below where I put the last color. Now I'm just going to be taking this Coastal Scents eyeshadow pot in Wild Raisin. It's this dark purple brownish color. And I'm going to be taking that onto a slanted blending brush by Ulta. I'm just going to take a little bit of that and focus that on my outer corner. Lightly blending that in towards the crease. I'm just doing windshield wiper motions, so circling and then swiping. And just going to put that a little bit more up by the rest of the colors, swiping that into the crease. So it has a nice like little like, look at this. It has a nice little ombre effect of the browns into the purple. I'm going to take this orangey color from my Tarte palette onto the same E25 blending brush and put that right above that dark color. I also just want to get a little bit of that burst color back, so I'm going to take more of that oatmeal tan, quite a generous amount, and put that right over that as well. And then going back with my slanted blending brush and that purple color and applying that to the same spot as we did before, just deepening that inner corner. Now I'm going to be taking another Coastal Scents eyeshadow. This video is not sponsored by them, but I just love their eyeshadows. This is in Bright Copper, and I'm just going to put that on the rest of the spot where you can see my skin. So I'm going to take a flat brush. This Ulta one, and I'm going to spray it with some primer water, and then put that into the shadow and apply that right to the rest of my eye. Then I'm just going to be taking that purple color and going back over into the outer corner, blending that into the crease. And that is it for this. Oh, no. That's not it. Then I'm just going to be taking this white color right here from my Lorac palette. Or Lorac. I'm not sure everyone says it. And I'm just going to be using that as my brow bone highlight. And I'm probably going to change it once I put highlighter on my face. I'll probably use something from the glow kit. So I am finished with this eye. Now I'm just going to take some scotch tape and apply that in an angle to my eye so I can do my eyeliner. I'm going to be using the Tartist liner because since we have glitter on our, like, glitter pretty much on our eyes, normal liquid liners won't really stick to that. And this will just assure that your eyeliner will stay and not smudge and stay in place all day throughout prom. So you're just going to want to start your eyeliner in the middle of your eye and then drag down and start going towards the inner. And then creating the wing. And voila, you have a perfect wing. Perfect. So let me go do my other wing off camera real quick just to save my camera's battery because you about to die. And I'll be right back. Now that the liner is done and perfect, we're just going to start with our face makeup. So today I'm going to be taking my Lancome 24-hour makeup. This does have SPF in it, which you really want to avoid when you're going to prom because flash photography and using SPF has a flashback. So I would not recommend wearing this because it does have SPF in it. if you could find something without SPF that does have a very good coverage, then I would totally recommend that. But as you know in my last video, my foundation is all out, so I had to improvise. Oh my god, I didn't put primer on. Good. But before we do that, we're just going to prime our face. So I'm going to be using these two primers together. This is the Baby Skin and the Master Prime. And I have noticed that my pores have been extremely huge lately, so I'm just going to make sure that doesn't happen on prom. Also, priming your face on prom will help you a ton with your foundation, especially staying on longer, because primers make foundation stick. And if you do want your foundation to stay on all day, I would highly recommend Nivea aftershave cream for men. I've heard that that works phenomenally. So yeah, don't do the mistake of jumping to the gun and putting on foundation before your primer, because that's just no good, girl. You ain't gonna get anywhere. So I'm just gonna put this all over. Make sure you blend it in very well. Also, I'm using a damp beauty blender to blend this. If you have dark under eyes, I would recommend color correcting those with a orange color correcting. And if you have red skin like me, I would suggest to color correct with a green color corrector. I know that LA Girl sells some that are very nice as well. Now that my foundation is on, I'm just going to be putting a powder foundation over, because we do want this to stay all day. So I'm just going to be using my Infallible Pro Matte Foundation and wiping that bad boy all over my face, just not under my eyes. And in the middle of my forehead. We don't want that there. Now I'm going to be taking my Morphe concealer palette, and I'm just going to be using one of these concealers and applying that under my eye. Not sure which concealer yet. Probably one that is not too light for under my eyes, because I don't want to look that incredibly light. So one that's just maybe a shade lighter than my foundation. So now I'm going to be using my Coty Airspun powder and baking my face, because girl, we do not need to be sweating all this hard work off at prom. So just bake away. Even though when you bake, you get powder everywhere, do it anyways. Also, bake your forehead if you do this like I do. Because we don't want them creases. We need to be flawless AF. So now while I'm letting that bake, I'm just going to be taking a cream contour, because cream products do stay on longer, and prom, you need things to stay on longer. So I'm going to be taking Tarte the Sculptor contouring stick, and I'm just going to place that where I regularly would contour. It's really not that dark, but it's okay. Then I'm just going to be taking the little brush that came with my little sample thingy. I'm just going to use that. It's a kabuki brush, and I'm just going to buffer that in. And after I do that, I'm just going to set that cream product, because we always set cream products. I'm just going to be using my Wet n Wild contour little palette, and taking and taking my Sigma E40 angled brush, I'm just going to put that right over the top and blend that up. Always want to blend up. Also going to take that little bit on my forehead just so I look more even. Then around my jawline to get that fat chin out of there. Just so your shadows, and you cannot see that chin anymore. So, now that we have our contour done, and I'm pretty sure our baking's probably done too, we're just going to brush that away. An additional step is putting a banana powder, which is included in the Wet n Wild, this color right here. That is optional, that is not needed, but if you want your makeup to look cakey, then hey, maybe you could do it. So I'm going to be taking that first blending shade we had, which is Oatmeal Tan, in my E25 blending brush, and put that right under my eye. Then I'm just going to take that angled brush that we used for the copper color, and I'm just going to take that purple color and put that right on my tight line. So my camera had died, but I didn't do much. I took this purple color and put that right on my tight line. Then I took that copper color and put it right next to that right there. And then I took my my brow bone highlight, and that was this color, and put that right in my inner corner. I also just put on some mascara and did my eyelashes. My eyelashes are the House of Lashes eyelashes in Heartbreaker. They're wispy, I love these ones. I'm wearing these ones to prom, actually. I'm not doing this makeup for prom, though. But anyways, that's irrelevant. Now I'm just going to take this Milani Baked Bronzer and put that right over my contour. This has a little bit of a shimmer in it. Now, for blush, I'm just going to take this shade right here. It's not a very pinky shade, but it's pretty. I'm going to take that on my Tarte blush brush and just put that right above my contour and bronzer and just blend that together. Now, taking my glow kit from Anastasia Beverly Hills, I'm going to take Bubbly and I'm going to take these two. They're very, very similar, but I'm going to take both of them and apply that to my cheekbones, right about on my temples and above my brow and on my nose. Highlight is like my favorite part. Is it any of your guys's? Comment below if highlight is your life. I just love highlighter, and especially this glow kit. I mean, it's to die for. Look at that highlight. The highlight is to die for. So before my lips, I'm just going to spray my whole face with primer water so that my makeup stays all day throughout prom and all the pictures that I need to be taking. Just drench my face in it. I feel like my forehead didn't get any. And that is it for the face. Now for the lips, I know I want to do something neutral because the eyes are so bold, and this eye look can really be done with neutral dresses, nothing out there, because this look is so in. I'm just gonna give a close up on my eyes. Eyelashes, this whole makeup look. For the lips, I'm just going to do nude lips colors. The NYX Simply Nude color in Sable, and the Simply Matte one, and I don't know. And also this L'Oreal. This Revlon lipstick, which is like a pinky in Sassy Mauve. So I'm just going to apply the Revlon one first. This really is a pinky. It's really pink. And on top of that, the NYX Matte Lip Cream. Those are the lips, and it's just a neutral lip because of this bold eye. So, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this out-of-the-box kind of prom makeup. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!